Remember that the person sitting across from you is a human being that wants to have a connection and a conversation with you. They don't need to grill you on these standard interview questions. What's up, guys? Dr. Ryan Gray back for another video about the medical school interview. Now, last week, if you've been following along, I covered the different types of medical school interviews. This week, I want to cover two of the most common questions that you need to have answers to. And that is, tell me about yourself and why do you want to be a doctor? So let's start with tell me about yourself. A lot of students dread this question, and it's a very common, a very easy question that interviewers can start with to get the ball rolling. Where most students go wrong with tell me about yourself is they recite their resume. They say, I recently graduated from this school, I majored in this, I did research in this, I studied blah, 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 I'm an excellent person, I've mentored 300 students, I've cured cancer, I've saved the world's hunger, whatever. They try to sell themselves way too much to come off over the top and prove to the interviewer that they're gonna be an amazing physician, that this interviewer shouldn't pass them up to be part of the class. That is not the way to answer tell me about yourself. The right way to answer tell me about yourself is to start it with a conversation to allow it to continue into a conversation. Now, what does that mean? That means talking about things that may interest the interviewer on a personal level. Not showing off and talking about all of the amazing things that you've done. I like to reframe this question as who are you and what do you do for fun? Let's talk about who are you. Family, where are you from? Literally, where are you from? Did you immigrate to the country? Have you lived in other parts of the country? Are you a dual citizen and travel to other parts of the world? Are you a sibling? Do you have brothers? Do you have sisters? Do you live with your grandparents and not your parents? How were you raised? That is who you are, where are you from? Talk about that. Not where you went to school, not where you went to high school, not what you majored in. That is not who you are or where you are from. The what do you do for fun part is really where an interviewer can latch onto. Let me give you an example. I had a student several years ago who was a non-traditional student, was an actor, and after some health issues with her dad, realized that she wanted to go to medical school. And she gave up acting, went and did a post-bac, and did really well in her post-bac, did well in the MCAT, and had tons of interviews to go on. And time after time after time in her interviews, all she talked about was acting, because it came up or they saw it in her application, and the interviewer said, oh, that's interesting, I want to talk about that. Remember that the person sitting across from you is a human being that wants to have a connection and a conversation with you. They don't need to grill you on these standard interview questions. And so if you can talk about your love for soccer, your love for basketball, your love for baking, your love for traveling, your love for exercise, anything that you do, that you love, that you're passionate about, that you would potentially like to talk about for 5 or 10 or hopefully 15 or 20 more minutes, that would be awesome to bring up. And don't just say, I love to read, I love to cook, I love to hike. Go a level deeper. What do you like to read? Is there a genre of books that you like to read? What was the last book you read? If you like watching movies, what was the last movie that you saw? Because hopefully the interviewer will go, oh, that's a great movie, I just saw that one. Or, oh, I'm going to see that this weekend, what did you think about it? Ideally, remember, this is a conversation with another human being. If you cannot get into this conversation, and not always can you, every interviewer is going to be a little bit different, but most times you'll be able to get into this conversation with an interviewer if you allow it, if what you're talking about and if how you start off the tell me about yourself question, if it will allow it. You want to throw out these little bits of thread so that the interviewer goes, oh, that's interesting, I wanna talk about that. Oh, that's interesting, I wanna talk about that. And then you talk about that, and then you move on. That is the best way to talk about tell me about yourself. Now, in my book, if you've read my book, again, The Pre-Med Playbook Guide to the Medical School Interview, I actually talk about a little bit of a different technique to also include and bring it back around to why medicine. Now, I wrote this book a couple years ago. I actually don't teach that anymore because 90%+ of students didn't do it very well. And so I said, just don't add that in there. Just end with all the fun stuff that you do. They're gonna ask, why do you wanna be a doctor? And so let them ask that question and you can get into that. All right, so let's move into that question. Why do you want to be a doctor? Now, to me, this seems like a very simple question. And obviously, I'm on this side of it. I've been through this process. I went to medical school. I worked as a physician, so it's easy for me to say, right? I'm not stressing out about getting in anymore. But why do I think it's easy? Well, you're interviewing. You've already written your personal statement, which hopefully talked about, why do you want to be a doctor? And so the question in your interview is the same question, and it's going to be a very similar answer. Here is where the seed was planted, and here are the experiences or conglomeration of experiences that led me to continue to want to be a physician. Do not, absolutely do not, try to say that you like science and you want to help people. Students love to try to come up with fancy ways to say these two things. Those two things, liking science and wanting to help people, are basic prereqs to wanting to be a doctor. You have to dive deeper. You have to dig deeper into your journey, your reasons, your experiences to understand why you want to be a doctor and to be able to communicate that in your personal statement and in your interview. If at the end of an interview, the interviewer doesn't understand why you want to be a doctor, there's a good chance that you will not get an acceptance. And a lot of students will lose an acceptance because of this. They got the interview, the stats were good, the personal statement was good, the secondaries were good, but then being able to verbalize and communicate the reasons for wanting to be a physician just don't come across. And unfortunately, medical school's really hard. And if students are there who don't really understand why they want to be a doctor, there's a very good chance that those students don't do well, don't finish medical school, don't pass the boards the first time, and struggle all along the way. And so schools want to make sure that you're doing this for the right reasons. So those are the two big, very simple, very common questions that students struggle with, but hopefully after watching this video, you have a leg up in answering these questions to get across who you are and why you want to be a doctor. Don't forget, check out my book, The Pre-Med Playbook Guide to the Medical School Interview. We'll have a link in the description. You can check it out on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, wherever you buy books. And again, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell notification to get notified of new videos every week. I'll see you next time.